So joining me on the show today in the studio, H and AJ Tracy, everybody.
In the building.
Good boys, what's good?
What's happening, you good?
Yeah, I love the new tune, Rain. This is wicked. This is just like what the UK is about at the moment. Everyone's working together.
Come on.
It's produced by Tay Keith, who's from overseas. Man. Does a lot of good stuff in America.
Yeah.
I said to your management before you came in, this is like the hand in hand we need to have on the States. How are you feeling about this tune?
I'm excited. What's the word I'm looking for? I'm just happy that it's out there, innit? And
me too.
We went through a bit of a process to get it out.
Really?
How was it hard?
Nothing to do with us though, but like we just went through a process, bruv. All music is politics, innit? We got it sorted though,
but
bro.
If the process is too smooth before a song comes out, it means it's not going to be a banger.
That's facts.
But when there's a bit of a hiccup,
because when it comes out and it bangs, you have to be able to look back and be like, oh, it almost never came out.
I want my name before AJ Tracy.
For me and him, because it was so normal when we made the tune, right? It was nothing like, there's no complications from us, innit?
Yeah.
It just powers that beast.
Is
like,
it two teams? Is it like, your team?
It's like four teams, but me and his team are sweet, innit?
Just twisting like knobs, treble there.
Yeah, basically.
And then obviously sometimes people talk to people without talking to the other. Do you know what I mean? It's just,
do you like it, radio? That's what happens here, bruv.
You know it's mad, yeah? Because we're not media chain, but we know how to speak, innit? So we don't say anything, but we're saying something. We're not saying anything, though. It's giving you a runaround, innit?
Take what you want from this, innit? I was even chatting to Colin the other day. We were speaking about it. It was almost too smooth. For it to, where's the bump?
From making it to it coming out, it was almost like just one.
But the bumpy road has been like the last 3 days, like the three days before it came out.
Oh, okay.
But we saw it. It's good.
And it's
good.
A banger.
So we can play it. We're not going to have like
all good.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Because we might have to cut it here. Who actually reached out to who? Because I think, personally, I see it as like a, this had to happen sooner or later.
We knew we had to collab at some point and like we kept linking each other, but like I personally don't remember. I'm not even saying it to be like PC, like I actually don't remember who shouted who on the day, innit? But we linked up by boy on the day. We just linked up.
I think we had studio anyway, innit? I was on Ladbroke Grove I was just like, yo, I'm local.
What's Ladbroke Grove like? Did he oversell it, undersell it?
Nah, you just, you know what? As soon as you see the sign, you just think of you.
I rate that.
Property prices have gone up, bruv.
Because of AJ, you get
I read that.
Brexit.
I read that.
even my girl, when the first time she went there, she took a picture of the sign and then added the music to it.
I read that.
Coming back to that Ladbroke Grove tune, and I said last time we spoke, I said it was Song of the Summer.
Mm.
It's still one of the biggest songs out there because nan bumps that tune. I'm not even joking. Big up Sheila.
She says it in such a posh way.
Yo, it's AJ Tracy. Direct. Go on,
I love that. I love that.
Where's Ladbroke Grove?
I love that still.
Big tune.
When it comes to collabing with artists, like, obviously you get along, but you know, music is political in some ways. Is it hard finding the right person to collaborate with? Is there people you? I don't. I'm not asking you to name names because I'm not ready for Wiley Stormzy again. Is there some? Do you have your go-tos? Let me say that.
Yeah.
I reckon there's little formulas, isn't there?
Of course.
I wouldn't say, I don't know. I wouldn't originally work with someone if I didn't think there was less anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you know what I mean? I've never 100%. Met someone for the first time and worked with them. I don't think.
Yeah.
What could put you off an artist? Like, okay, so say you listen to...
Loads of things, bro. It's like a million things.
Attitudes.
A million things, yeah. That's the main one. Obviously, for me, it's just that, like, I consider myself a normal guy, genuinely, like, not trying to be some hippie or nothing, but genuinely, like, man's a normal guy to the point where, like, bruv, what I do in my spare time is the same as what everyone else does in their spare time. I play FIFA or whatever, like, in my boxes, bruv, honestly, like, do you know what I'm saying? I go link my mates and have a drink or whatever, but you get my point, innit? It's normal stuff, man. So when I meet someone else, an artist, and they're acting like they're proper, like, on a pedestal, and they're living this magical life that, like, they're untouchable, I don't like that. I don't want to chill them, because that's not relatable, because I'm not like that either.
Do you know what I'm saying?
So when I meet someone like H or like Notes, you know what I'm saying, these people, like, to me, like, they're cool guys, like, they're just normal people, bruv. So it's easier for me to connect with them. Man, in studio, you need to build a vibe. Because imagine me and him go perform this tune now at a festival and we didn't really mess with each other, then it's going to be a bit awkward. We'd be looking at each other like, you stay on your side, this thing, like, you know what I'm saying?
Overperforming.
Yeah, I sat down.
We mentioned Tay Keith, produce a tune. Because you've got your last couple of tunes have been with like, what I would call heavy hitter producers. They've like Tay Keith is incredibly known. In the States. Now, is this a vibe that the whole of the UK should be doing? Because like I said, I think we need to
take it away.
I think we need to.
I don't think. I hear what you're okay. saying. I don't think anyone should be doing anything.
Yeah, do you know what I mean?
Okay. I feel like it is what it is, isn't it? Like, as in, I don't think, yo, because we've done this now, you need to start fucking with American producers or you need to... AJ set pace with that anyway. AJ, you're done the cat pack one the other day, that, you get me? But even before that, but I don't think anyone needs to do anything. I don't think, like, you should just be you, do you get what I mean? I'm not going to, like... It might work. I might make a banger, but I'm not gonna go start doing an Afro swing on on a J5.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, and expect everyone to love it because that's just not my lane. In a way, do you get what I mean?
I know what you mean. Yeah, you know but, what I do at the same time do like about both of you artists, you can jump on anything.
Oh yeah,
but me and him as well. We got like our actual producers that we work with the most. You know what I'm trying to say, we got our go-to guys who's actually our legends, and then obviously we work with whoever else we want to work with.
Yeah.
So like both me and him are fans of Tay Keith production. You know what I'm saying, we're like, oh, let's give it a whack. Doesn't mean that every tune we do, next one's gonna be like. Obviously, I actually mess with these producers. I'm just saying these ones because they're off the top of my head.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's not going to mean the next one's going to be like Murder Beats and then the next one's going to be da-da-da, you know what I'm saying? It doesn't have to be massive heavy hitters in a row. It's just whatever sounds good, man. I just think if it's good music, it's good music.
Of course.
Like, he could produce the beat himself and no one would know. I don't think it's bare hard. You know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah, that's exactly what I was just about to say. Yeah. Like, today it could be Tay Keith. Tomorrow I might find one in my email off Danny Beats from Leicester or something. You know what I mean? And if it's if it's hard, it's hard. You know what I mean? So I don't personally think anyone should be doing anything. I think you just do you and then it.
But you've got to show some love to UK producers who are smashing in the States. You know, Axel Beats, M1.
That's my guy. Shout out Axel.
You know what I mean? UK producers are the coldest, no matter what anyone says.
Okay, so this is the question. Are they underrated?
Coldest.
Yeah.
Are they underrated? Do they need...
I'm having this conversation this morning.
They're underrated outside the UK because they're rated.
Why?
We rate them here. Here, they're rated. You know what I'm saying?
See if American Man came in the studio with us and he was with Nige or YJ or any of these people, just start making a rhythm. These Americans will be like,
"Yeah, I swear, on my left." I swear, on my left.
Was it County Lines? Kodak Black on his Instagram.
Yeah. You love that one still.
But I personally feel like when, like I said, because I was gassed to see that Tay Keith. I was gassed to see Tay Keith producing this.
Yeah.
Do you think the love needs to be spread over to especially in the New York drill scene, for instance, where they are killing it?
They're killing it still. Yeah, no.
Do you think there needs to be more of them at the front face? The
New York
kind of version.
New York and Toronto, they're exclusions because they've been messing with us from day. Like, that's the
in a good way.
Yeah, Toronto, New York, and London's been linked up from earlier, so that doesn't even count. But you see, like places like LA, they need to open their ears a little bit. I think to our sound because
I personally feel with LA, I've been twice and they follow trends.
Yeah, exactly that.
And I don't think you should ever go to LA and do
if me and H go LA, and that we tell everyone, yo, this song is hot, like this is what we're dropping, this is a hard tune, there's gonna be like, ooh, you know what I'm saying? But if Rocky comes out and says, oh, you see that H and AJ tune, if Rocky says it, now it's lit, now they want to listen to it. But the song sounded the same before Rocky said it, but so it's just that now that my man said it, like, you rate it, do you get it?
That's LA.
That is LA.
Do you think the cosigns are more important building up these relationships with these artists? Just because...
Shall I be honest?
Go on.
Yes, to be honest.
Do you need to be mixing with these circles?
No, you don't have to. Again, what he said, I don't think anyone should be doing anything or you should have to. To be honest, look, you can look at like Stormzy, he's the king of Europe in my personal opinion. I'm just saying,
Untouchable.
But like, I'm not saying he doesn't care about America. I can't speak for him, you know what I'm saying? But from what it looks like, he's not really focused on smashing America and it'll come when it comes, you know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
Like, he's focused on being the king of his backyard first, which is what I think everyone should be doing. That's what I do think you should be doing.
Because
if you try and be like, I'm from Labrador, so imagine me, everyone knows me in the ends and I'm trying to be big in like Manny, for example. Like, Manny might actually mess with me, but then everyone in Grove's like, what, you didn't want to like show us love and be big here before you went off to Manny, you know what I'm saying? And then you get that kind of thing where your own hometown don't mess with you, but someone else
does. Because you're not showing love to, you're showing love to the end.
Yeah, come on, bro. Even the streets, bro. When you make, like me and him, like, I noticed H does this as well. Me and him make tunes that might be commercially like viable, but also we need to feed the ends as well, bro. You can't just feed everyone and not the other. Like, everyone has to eat. You get me? Bucket meal for the family. Facts.
Family bucket.
Chicken cottage. Do you know what I mean?
So, yeah, I know my chicken cottage.
Yeah. That's what I mean. What is it? £9.24.
Is that the one on Grove?
Bagging. Yeah, cottage is bagging.
All right, let me down that, you know.
I tell you this one.
You let me down, you know.
You're lying. You got the wrong thing. You must have got the wrong thing.
Nah.
Do you know when you get wings? Do you know when you get wings or something?
But what wings did you get?
It's just pure crisp. There ain't no chicken. Like,
okay. You got a bad batch. You got a bad batch.
It must have been the last. It must have been the last ones.
We were getting on. Do you know what I mean?
I'll forever be honest. I could never guess
fair
it.
Fair play.
Before we move off the American stuff, have you actually heard American audiences or seen American audiences react to music? One thing I like to do is look at. I like to follow a YouTuber called Layback.
Yeah.
And he listens to a lot.
Reactions.
Yeah. And I feel like. What I feel listening to like your music and and Stormzy's music and just the whole UK wave we've got at the moment is just being expressed, and they're so confused by how good it is. Have you heard these American audiences? Have you seen these American audiences?
Yeah, I've seen a couple. I've seen, you know about No Life Shaq? You know about Shaq?
I think so, yeah.
Shaq's funny. Shaq was like the first person to ever react to me when I've done it, so I've been locked in on him.
Have you?
I speak to him and that.
Do you?
On the gram,
Do you little slapping? Oh, I'm doing this tune. Do you mind?
But you know what he does do though? Because he's in the States. He sends me the link.
Yeah.
And I need to clear it or something.
To make sure the audio doesn't get taken down.
That's easy though, innit? Because you just have to write something underneath.
Yeah, literally.
You can whitelist their channel, innit? So that whenever they upload your music, the label says that's fine. Like.
There you go.
Oh, sick. Hey, that's what we'll talk later on. but you know, I do like, especially like with some really influential people. Like, I'm not saying that Kylie Jenner should be a fan of UK music, but you know, she was pumping Darko, man. And this is great, and it's just showing that UK.
I was on my. Do you know what's mad, yeah? This is going to sound so gassed, I'm sorry, but it's just a reality. See, when I open my Insta, the notifications, people think that I'm gassing, but. Like, you know when someone says, did you see me like your picture? It's like, bruv, of course I didn't. Like, there's like 100 a minute, yeah, like, I don't see it. But. What I did see is I had bare fans DMing me saying, go on, I think it was Bella, was it Gigi? One of them. Go on her story. I went on her story. And she was listening to Quarterback and she was vibes. And I was like, all right.
But you know what the baddest thing is? She's got no idea what that's about.
Yeah, that's why it's mad. But you know what it is? It's because she's around people like, you know, like Virgil, for example. Yeah. And I'm friends with a lot of like people from Toronto who hang around with her, you know what I'm saying? So they would have been like, oh, maybe listen to this. Let me take the aux and let me just play a sneaky. There's like a Drake mix right now and then one AJ chin and they're like,
like Zayn. Right, he's heavily loves the UK music scene.
Like, Ed Sheeran as well, like bro. Adele, you get me. I know they all listen to the
everyone's
man.
Everyone's co-signing, man.
100%.
But you know, before we come in, we're just all chatting in general. Like, you guys are living it. It's well deserved. You're honestly at the top of your game. Do you get a posh invite to certain places every now and then? Like, because we saw you in some posh Japanese restaurant. Eating sushi.
Oh. That was in LA, though. That.
So how are you and the boys reacting to that? Because
I walked out when I seen the bill.
We don't like chicken cottage.
Nah, do you know what? That was my first time at Nobu.
Really?
Where did you take me? Hakusan?
Novikov.
So I've got a discount for Hakusan, by the way.
You're all smashing it more than me. What are you going on about? Because he's took me to my first. What's it called?
Novikov.
They're all the same.
Don't let this guy act like he don't eat a fancy restaurant. Don't let him fool you for the camera.
No,
what's it called?
I swear to God. LA was the other week was my first time I went Nobu. Bad dog. I'm definitely gonna go again. Sushi. Yeah. Since you got me on sushi, you got me knowing how to use chopsticks.
I read that, my guy.
Do you know the higher you go up in the chopsticks is more you're more respected.
Is it?
Yeah.
Because it's harder, innit?
I had a Chinese housemate when I was at uni and I was right at the bottom trying to eat.
The top.
And he was at the top and he looked at me like, he was like,
you amateur.
Tommy, get me a fork.
That's funny still.
Now, I just mess with it though. I like nice steak restaurants. I don't be busting the mad food. I just like my
Harvesters,
nice steak.
Harvesters, you know what I mean?
Have you heard about
Hawksmoor?
Hawksmoor.
Yeah. Never been there.
Hawksmoor, that's the one.
I've never been, but I heard it's the one.
Yeah, I went to STK a couple of weeks ago. Discount again.
Did you take a picture of Insta? That's what they would do, innit?
Of course I did. Last time you come in here, right? You said your nan doesn't listen to your music. She's not allowed to listen to her music. Is she listening now? Or
no, she stays locked in and that. But I can't help swearing. I don't even mean to, but I obviously swear a lot.
Do you have to give her like a little warning?
Even I went for a little meal. I went for a meal for my granddad's birthday the other day, and my auntie and uncle came in. They've got kids and that, and he was like, can you not do no clean versions and just send it us?
No. No.
No.
I'm living.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's funny.
Yeah, there is clean versions, obviously, on radio and that, but...
Just about that. What you said us the other day.
Oh, damn.
What you said us the other
day. It's mad, yeah, it's mad. Say that.
Because, like, last time we spoke...
Yeah.
You said you had a track with Georgia Smith, garage track.
Yeah, mad.
Who's heard it? Have you heard it? Oh, come on.
I got a preview.
Have you got a preview? Right. Okay, look. Three words. Describe it. Describe the track. Because I
this is the one I have heard, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Banger.
It's
I don't want to give it a name because I don't want to, but I was going to say it's Ladbroke Grove Part 2, I was going to say.
That's how I describe it, but better. I think it's better than Ladbroke Grove.
Yeah, but
No, I'll be honest with you. Yeah? Okay. I'm not just saying this now because it done well, yeah, but honestly, I'm bored of that song now. That's just the truth. It's the truth. It is what it is.
I'm not saying nothing, but...
Bruv, a kid saw me the other day, yeah? I was walking out down the road, yeah, and he's like, AJ Chasey, and he went, and I went, yeah, live and direct, I know. And he's like...
No,
what he was going to say. I knew he was going to say that. It's so obvious. All right, bro, I get it. Leave me alone, bro. It's so dumb.
But that's the thing, though. But that's the poison chalice of it, man.
Of course,
you've got,
yeah, of course.
You've got a heavy
tune. No, of course.
That means it was the right song.
Facts. 100%, bro. I'm not ungrateful for it. Of course, I'm happy that I done well with it, but it's just like, come on, man.
You know what I mean? All right, okay, cool. I'm not going to get into
it. I know that's what you wanted to say.
I'm not saying that I know. I'm just saying, no, but okay, I can understand what you're saying.
Yeah, man.
So... But no, I saw on TikTok, yeah. Actually, do you know what? I'm going to start with you first because I've seen you up on Insta with your missus. Was you in Jamaica, was it?
We was in Bali.
Bali, right? Looking incredible. It was amazing.
That's a compliment to me, yeah. Thank you.
What's going... No, but like your lifestyle, like how you're living, you got your missus on the gram. What's going on with you? Because the amount of people, because in this job...
A lot of people
Before we get into this, I'm not even putting you on the spot. I swear
this is long.
I swear I post my missus more than you.
You might do, yeah.
So you've got a missus?
Yeah.
Fine, okay, cool.
That's all you wanted to know.
No, because all I ever get right is when I play H, yeah? No, not like that.
No, I didn't mean it like that either.
Do you know what I mean? If that was the case, you wouldn't be here, AJ.
Solo dolo.
No, because all I get, right, when we talk about H, so my cousins, my younger sister, she's like, oh, has H actually got a girlfriend? And I'm like, oh, so you've definitely got a girlfriend.
That's all for the camera, it's all the image.
Is it?
You never know.
Is it the girl off TikTok? There was a girl on TikTok.
Nah, that girl who pretends to be my girl and that.
Yeah.
No.
You sure?
Nah.
She's outside.
100%.
Do you know what? Firm. Have you seen her? Do you know what? She does a good job, though. She's good at what she does. Like,
good promo.
She's good at what she does, yo. She manages to look like she's sat with me. Like, oh. I don't know. She's not sat with me.
Technology, these whippersnappers.
Yeah, but nah, she's good. She's good at what she does. But nah, that's not my girlfriend. My girlfriend don't have TikTok or anything like that. So you're trying to find my girlfriend.
You know what it is for us, yeah? Well, I'll speak on both of us, yeah. You know what it is for us? Like, obviously, bro, we both got girls and like, yeah, that's our normal life. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah,
that's our personal life. So I feel like we don't need to broadcast it. Like,
of course.
We don't need to I'm not out here saying I don't have a girl because I do.
Yeah,
and if I feel like posting it, I'll post it. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
If
we
feel like it, but no one could tell me why don't you post your girl, like, bro, it's none of your business, you know, like that.
No, you're right.
Yeah, but for me it's always been a tricky one to be an artist with a girlfriend because it's like you feel like genuinely, I swear down, girls make you feel like you're wrong for having a girlfriend, which is just weird.
I thought,
like,
I was gonna lose,
you know what I'm
fans.
Saying yeah, now you know what it is, they like to say that.
Sorry.
Oh, I saw a girl saying I'm gonna make all my female friends unfollow AJ now that he's got a girlfriend. I was like, that is mad. If you're being serious, that is mad.
So I think it was at the Brits and there was like a girl's hand on your leg. The man of Fiat 500 Twitter went off, bruv.
Yeah. Oh, my. That
Fiat 500. That life is over.
Do you know what? They should change that to H to that whole
man
name.
Fiat
that's all about me. That, I swear. All I see is that, yo, when people... Because I don't even go on Twitter, innit? I don't even have Twitter on my phone.
Yeah.
But when people say that to me, I just think, oh, no.
Fiat 500, yeah, that's funny, fam.
The Pied Piper Fiat 500.
Yeah. I had to block a kid driving the other day, yeah, because he kept commenting under. Every time I talk about Rain, he comments, yeah. He's the first one to comment, so he's obviously got notifications on there.
First.
Yeah. He writes... Oh, Fiat 500 is going to love this. And then he writes, oh, they can't wait to hear this blasting out of girls' Fiat 500. And the third time he did it, yeah, I saw his comment. It was like 3 seconds old. I just blocked him. I was like, I've had enough of you. I've had enough now.
You got the head of marketing
the rain
the other day. We've messed up.
There was one on the Rain video the other day. It said something like, as soon as I posted it within 30 seconds, I can't wait for the 13-year-old white girls.
Yeah.
On the, So what, bro?
Like, know, yeah, I don't get it. What's the problem?
That's why you're wearing Stone Island and you got a big old coat on.
Come on, but I don't get it though. Like, what's the problem? You know what I'm trying to say? I've never seen a problem with any. I don't care what demographic listens to my music, but I'm happy for them to be listening to my music.
Do you
saying.
Know what? I think you're in a good. I think you're in a good. Let's call it the Goldilocks area.
Yeah, it's the sweet spot. It's the sweet spot.
It's the sweet spot.
Shoot.
Are you gonna link up with any Manny guys? You know,
yeah,
on a track today. Or
I've actually got. Robert Hollow, whether you know him or not, he just dropped a tape. I'm on that tape.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So when people start chatting to me about you don't do nothing for the city, you can go over there because I'm on man's tape. You know what I mean? Yeah, you haven't heard the tape. I'm on man's tape. You know what I mean?
Some people just don't like listening.
I'm on man's tape. Manchester, look, do your research in Manchester. I'm on bare man's tune.
Come on.
Do you get
it's
me?
On the tape.
Anyway, yeah, I want to do, obviously I've done that. I want to do a tune with my guy Samer. Do you know about Samer?
No, tell me about
you. You will hear of him very soon. Yeah, got a couple of tunes popping at the minute. If nice. I played you the song, you'd probably think, oh yeah, I've heard that.
Yeah, yeah, familiar sound.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So Samer, Tunde, like you said, Tunde's my guy. He's in the States at the moment. No, I just missed him. When I was in the States, I just missed him. Yeah. So when he's back, we get some time, we'll get
nice.
In there.
Get him on and, another tape.
Yeah. Just do whatever. And I'm looking to do a little thing where like H2O, I had Tyreezy on it, he's from Manchester.
Yeah,
every tape I try and I'm gonna try and have someone from Manchester on there.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna force it, but
because
then you'll end up like, there. Do you remember that program, the Class of 92? Like the football program. We'll have that in like a couple of years.
That's
time.
Us.
We've got to give it up. What a couple of guys. AJ Tracy. Thank you
in the
so
building.
Much
Come
for
on.
Coming
Thanks
here.
For having Thank us. You, Thanks for having
Rain
us.
Rain out now.
Yeah, me.
Splash.
Whoosh. The beat of the UK.